And welcome to The Factor Uncensored tonight. Today, Mayor Sylvester Turner dropped a bombshell that has left the city talking. He says the Houston Independent School District is one step closer to being taken over by the state of Texas. He says the Texas Education Agency plans to take control in the next few days, with 273 schools and 190,000 students. There are concerns about how it could affect everything from jobs to communities. We gathered our guests, State Representatives Jolanda Jones and Ron Reynolds, along with State Senator Paul Bettencourt.
So, State Senator Paul Bettencourt, is this good news, bad news, indifferent to it? What does this mean?
Well, look, the TEA has really three options in a situation like this, and they had those options before they filed suit, and the options were to place a conservator in at HISD, close Wheatley High School, or put in a board of managers. Now, that decision has not been announced, but those options are all on the table. And really, all the lawsuit that HISD did was delay all this for almost 3 years. And in the intermediate time, I passed Senate Bill 1365, which restored the entire A through F accountability system, because that was what was stopping that lawsuit from being decided upon. And Supreme Court made it very clear that the TEA has the authority and they can make these decisions. And they've already done one. And the question is now, will they do either one of the other two that we've discussed?
Now, do you think they would be headed in the right direction if they took over HISD in some form or fashion? Your personal opinion here, Senator.
Well, I mean, at this point in time, what I'm worried about is, everybody has seen the reports from 3 years ago. Actually, Representative Jolanda Jones is the only trustee that was not mentioned in that report from 3 years ago of having an issue. Okay. Now, the issues were voluminous and numerous and troubled. Now, since then,
And really quick, Senator, before you go on, because some of the viewers may not be familiar with that report 3 years ago, give us some specificity on the problems that they found in the district back then. Not a long list, abbreviated version.
Contract problems, hiring problems, hiring an interim superintendent at a Mexican restaurant and firing him 3 days later at a public press conference, violating every Open Meetings Record Act law we have in the state of Texas. Yeah, there was a bunch of problems.
Now, I was there doing that, Isaiah.
Right. So,
let me be clear. I was the only trustee, as Senator Bettencourt said, that did not break the law.
Right.
And what they did was they had a walking quorum. They decided to illegally fire the then superintendent, Dr. Granita Layton, and replace him with Abe Saavedra without telling anybody. And then we forced them to do the right thing, which is why they ended up firing Saavedra. And he actually threw his name in when I told him I was going to tell the world a whole bunch of stuff that he did. He was like, I take my name out of it. So they did a lot of things, but there were three things that happened that triggered TEA's reasons for why they said they should be able to take over the board. If you'd like for me to tell you those, I will. There were three things.
At this point, Representative Jones, do you think TEA should take over the board? Why and
no,
why not?
No, they should not. One, their Wheatley is now at a C. The board that was doing all the crooked stuff, with the exception of one person, Trustee Elizabeth Santos, who was a part of the walking quorum, everybody's gone, right? So they don't have the walking quorum anymore. So, and any of the contract problems that they had back then are resolved. So they should not take it over. And I spoke with Mike Morath today, and they actually can't take it over until this triggering mechanism happens by the Supreme Court, which could happen as late as today. The last I heard, it had not happened. But I know that TEA's position, based on what Morath told me, is that he believes that they have to either appoint a board of managers or close Wheatley. And that's what he believes. But you know what? We can change the law, which is why Representative Allen and I are filing a bill tomorrow that abolishes the TEA.
How likely is that to occur, Representative Reynolds? And having TEA take over HISD, what will this mean for the students? Will there be an interruption of their education? And your thoughts on that?
It's great to have you. It's great to be on. I think Representative Jelona Jones is right. TEA should not be taking over HISD. They have done a remarkable job of turning the district around through extraordinary efforts. The new superintendent, Milton House, has done a phenomenal job, as well as the board is now functional. The board was dysfunctional. It was chaos. The chaos has been resolved. So TEA is taking, essentially ready to take away local control. I talked to Dr. Alma Allen. I support the efforts to abolish TEA. TEA is trying to take away local control. The local elected school board members are the closest to the community. They've done a remarkable job. There is no need to take over HISD at this point. We need to give HISD the support so that they can continue to flourish and educate the students and prepare them for the future.
Senator Bancourt, if things have been addressed like Representative Reynolds and Jones both have said, why should TEA move forward now if many of the problems in the past with the previous board, they've been resolved?
Well, first off, not all the problems have been resolved. And I'll just point to another case, because there was another trustee that actually took a federal indictment, okay, and accepted it. And we have the chief operating officer that's actually going to trial on corruption charges.
They're gone.
Well, that's a very complicated case involving multiple campuses, Ron. And don't tell me that a trustee and a COO could come up with that type of fraud on lawn care on multiple campuses all by themselves. There are people that are still at HISD that are part of that fraud case, and that bothers me. Now, the real point, Isaiah, is when we took Senate Bill 1365, when restored all the A4F, it's always had a point where that if there is an issue with a board of trustees, that the TEA could come in and put in a board of managers. Now, there's been takeovers like this, as big as El Paso and smaller districts. So at this point in time, Representative Jones is right. The decision is up to the TEA commissioner. And because I am worried about these other corruption cases that have still not been resolved, so I'll support his decision if that's what he decides to do.
Remember, don't go anywhere. We'll have much more on the discussion at HISD when we return here to The Factor Uncensored. Welcome back to The Factor Uncensored. The threat of the Texas Education Agency taking control of HISD has been stewing for quite some time. We can trace it back to 2019 after Whitley High School came in with low performance for 7 years straight. Fast forward to today, there are concerns about the future of the school once the TEA takes over. Our panelists continue their discussion here tonight.
Representative Reynolds, you were saying that those cases are now resolved, but he's saying there's still people in the weeds there.
He's talking about a former trustee who's no longer there. He's talking about a former CEO who was fired, who was terminated. So these issues have been resolved. He will have his day in court, but he's not at HISD. So are you now going to say if there are allegations against other school employees and other districts, TEA should take them over? No, that's nonsense. That's a slippery slope. HISD is one of the largest school districts in the country, and you have a few failing schools that have been turned around. This is ridiculous. This makes no sense. This is their ability to try to take over. They don't like the politics of the current board. Well, those board members are duly elected just like we are. And if we believe in local control, let them do their job. If they're not doing their job, the voters can replace them. So that is the system of government.
I'm sorry, TEA does not have a good record of taking over districts and improving them. They have not.
TEA's
existence, they have not significantly improved education. Perfect example, since Senator Bittencourt brought up the TEA takes over other districts, they took over North Forest. They didn't fix North Forest after they put in a board of managers, and then after they took over North Forest and couldn't fix it, they then forced HISD to take in North Forest. They were supposed to give us $150 million. They did not. And then HISD had new children who had been disenfranchised by TEA, and we're still struggling with that. So TEA should be held to the same standards that they're trying to hold HISD and other school districts to. And since they can't fix schools that they're charged with improving the educational outcomes, they should be abolished, like they're trying to abolish HISD's board and superintendent and put in a board of managers.
Let's hear from Senator Betancourt now. Senator, if North Forest is an example of the TEA moving in and taking control, that really is a bad example of them taking control.
Well, let me tell you this. I was the tax collector when North Forest was taken over. And for example, they assigned the collections to the Harris County Tax Office. The yield at North Forest was just 71 cents on the dollar. When we got in because of the TEA, we improved that yield to over 92 cents. So they were actually getting cash flow again in North Forest. I can't speak to the rest of it, but I can speak to that because I was there at that point. And look, when you look at TEA, of course they've done things. Why do you think Wheatley is at the point where there's been improvement? It's because of the TEA conservator that's already there. Now, we can have a discussion about at least the fact record, but the fact is that, I mean, you know, high schools like Cashmere have been on the NR list or the needs improvement list for nearly a decade. Now, I've had people testify as far back as 2015, HISD trustees, that they needed help with schools like that. So this has been a long-running problem, and we're coming to at least a conclusion here shortly. But the bottom line is, yes, TEA has been successful. Look at Wheatley High School as an example. That's a TEA conservator driving those changes.
Representative Reynolds, you're shaking your head. Go ahead.
You know what's funny? As a former HISD board member, and again, Senator Betancourt brought up Cashmere asking for help. Well, we had board members who didn't want to vote to give Cashmere the money to help. But guess what? Those board members are gone. They're out of here. They're out.
Isaiah, I'll just say this really quickly. If you do a report card on the TEA takeover and how successful they've been, they'll get an F. And so I support Representative Jones and Dr. Allen. If TEA wants to take over HISD, then I fully support a bill to abolish the TEA. This is nonsense. This, you're talking about, Republicans are supposed to be for less government and less bureaucracy and local control. This goes against everything that they stand for, and I am adamantly opposed to it. And okay, I will vigorously join my colleagues in support in opposition to it.
And Isaiah, let me just end with this. That's not what Republicans think. Okay, what Republicans want to see is success in the classroom for our children that we're spending taxpayer money. And it's very important that we don't leave schools on closure lists for a decade. It's very important that we take action when there are rogue boards. And I believe everybody, all three of us agree just how rogue that board was. But one of the things they did was they filed suit to try to delay and make it another decision. Now, the problem is that we had to go through legislation to file and change that. So I think at this point in time, I'm going to wait to see what the TEA decision is going to be. And if it is, knowing Mike Morath, it's going to be based on facts, because that's how he's worked with me and everyone that I've seen in the legislature for 8 years. But all this is going to be debated and will be continued to be debated, because the final decision hasn't been made or announced at this point.
All right.
If the state of Texas really supported HISD, they wouldn't make us give back to the state over $1 billion with Robinhood and give us less money than they give us. If the state of Texas and TEA was really committed to providing the students in HISD the money that they deserve, I think local taxpayer dollars should stay locally so that we can educate our children. And if the state of Texas didn't rob HISD to give to other areas, then we wouldn't have any problems educating our children.